So in the series of learning C programming, we are discussing structures in C. We have covered almost everything about structures in C. So in this video, we'll see one question on structure. And I guess we are left with the simple concept in structure, that is designated initialization of structures, of structure members, right? So that concept we'll discuss with the help of this problem, right? So, and if you are preparing for GATE 2023 or will be preparing for GATE examination, then An Academy is going to start a new batch from 22nd of December. In this course, the top educators will cover all the subjects of CS and IT, and that will help you to prepare for your GATE 2023 examination. This course will include strategy, tips and tricks, practice questions, numericals, along with the detailed explanation of the concepts. And this course will be covered in Hindi and English, and notes will be provided in English. And all your doubts related to any topic will be clarified during the doubt clearing sessions in the course. And that would be paid course, because you will get a complete and structured course. But you can use my code JKL10 to get 10% discount on this paid subscription. But more batch, they are going to start from 22nd of December for GATE 2023 and 2024 aspirants. That is Foundation plus Spark for GATE aspirants. In this batch, the top educator will cover all the subjects of CS and IT engineering. And same, this course will include some strategy, tips and tricks, practice questions, numericals, along with the detailed explanation of the concepts. But this course would be covered in English only, and the notes would be given to you in English. Same, the doubt clearing sessions would be there, so you can get your doubts cleared in those doubt clearing sessions. So for those who wants to crack GATE examination with some good rank, I think these courses would be very beneficial for you guys. So all the relevant links and the details I'll put in the description box of this video, and don't forget to use my code JKL10 to get 10% discount on An Academy Plus and Iconic courses. So now back to the topic. So what output you will get? Just pause the video and find out your output, and then write down in the comment box before watching the solution, right? Now let's discuss what is this question. This is what our example of designated initialization. Why I am saying this, that also we'll discuss, because we have initialized these members something like this. This is what designated initialization is. The meaning I'll tell you. Here we are having the structure. The name of the structure is question. Three members are there. Int, two are integer, one is float, right? In main, I'm just assigning some values, and I'm just printing like how to access these structure members. The name of the variable is q, dot operator, and the name of the member, q dot a, q dot b, q dot c. So what output you will get here? See, if you initialize something like this, rather than this line, I'm writing struct question q, and here I'm writing 1, 10, 15, right? I hope you can see the difference. One is this initialization, one is this. So in this case, what output you will get? This 1 would be initialized, 1 would be given to this A, this 10 would be in this B, and this 15 would be in this C. And when you will print, you will get what output? 1, 10 point, this float, so 6 zeros, and then C is 15, right? Because I have told you, whatever you will give here, the values, that these values would be assigned in the order. Whatever the first member, the first value would be assigned to this member only. So 1 would be given to this A, 10 would be to this B, and 15 to this C. Now, but I have initialized something like this. In these curly braces, I'm writing. See, dot operator is very important. You cannot access these members without dot operator, right? So dot B is equal to 1. Means this is what a designated initialization. I want this 1 would be given to this B. So this 1 would be given to this B. In this case, dot C means 10 would be given to this C, and this 15 would be given to this A. So in this case, if you will print Q dot A, Q dot B, Q dot C, then what output you will get? In A, we have 15. In B, we have 1.000, like 6 zeros. And in C, we have 10. Right? So I hope you can see the difference. Simple initialization, and this is what designated initialization of the members of the structure. You can run this and you can see you are getting the same output or not. Right? So this is the very small concept that was left in this structure, designated initialization of the structure members. I hope this is done. Now we are done with all the concept of structure. So from the next video, hopefully I'm going to start file handling in C. So now I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye. Take care. So see, this is the question. We have just done this designated initialization of in this question, right? Same we have discussed in that example, right, on the whiteboard. Now let me just save it and run it and see what output you will get here. See the 15, 1 point this, 0, 0 because it is float, and 10. But we are not doing this one. I am initializing it a simple way, that this is the way, right? Struct question Q, only we are writing the values 1, 10, 15, right? Now see what output you will get. It's now 1, 10 and 15, right? I hope now you can see the difference between these two initialization of the structure members.